Hashtag answers 7,000 sign petition demanding trial of Buhari at ICC. Hello, my amazing family. Trust that what belongs to you will always find you. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. An online petition has been launched on the web-based petition aggregator Change.org for the trial of President Muhammadu Buhari at the International Criminal Court, ICC. The petition, which garnered about 7,013 signatories Wednesday evening, this report is titled Petition to the ICC to Arraign Muhammadu Buhari for Crimes Against Humanity. The petition was initiated by Reino Omokri, a former special assistant to Nigeria's former president, Goodluck Jonathan. It reads, on October 20, 2020, the Buhari administration murdered multiple innocent, unarmed, peaceful, #insas protesters at the Lekki toll gate in a massacre that has since been dubbed #LekkiMassacre. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. These youths were protesting to put an end to the rampant police brutality that had become the hallmark of the Buhari regime, which treats so-called repentant Boko Haram almost like royalty, while coming hard on young Nigerians, sometimes for the flimsy reason such as wearing dreadlocks. Following the murders of these protesters, the Buhari administration denied that the incident ever occurred. They threatened those like myself who insisted with proof that this massacre happened. The government even threatened to jail people who called for those behind the murders to be brought to book. However, on Monday, November 15, 2021, the Lagos State Panel of Inquiry into NSAS released its report to the state government, in which it established judicially that not only did the massacre occur, but that the government of Muhammadu Buhari and his agents, the Nigerian Army and police, perpetrated the murders. This petition is therefore directed at the International Criminal Court to set machinery in motion for the trial of Muhammadu Buhari for crimes against humanity, in the same way that former Liberian President Charles Taylor was tried and convicted. On this day, November 17th, 2021, when my beloved twin sons are celebrating their 14th birthday, they have permitted me to use their special day to call for justice for the many sons and daughters who will never have another birthday because Buhari killed them in their prime. #BuhariForPrison2023. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. On Monday, the Lagos State Judicial Panel on Special Anti-Robbery Squad SARS related abuses submitted its report to the state government. The findings of the panel set up to investigate the shooting of peaceful protesters at the Lekki toll gate in Lagos confirmed in its report that at least 9 persons died. The report had also described the killings as massacre. It is no longer news that the truth about what happened at the Lekki toll gate on October 20, 2020 has been revealed, according to the report which was released by the judicial panel set up by Lagos State Government to investigate the Lekki toll gate shooting incident soldiers intentionally shot at protesters on that fateful day. It was also gathered that after the soldiers retreated, police officers continued the violence and made attempts to clean up the scene by getting rid of the bullets. It was also reported that officers of the Nigeria Army shot, injured, and killed unarmed protesters without provocation or justification, even though they were waving the Nigeria flag and singing the national anthem. However, while commenting on the report released by the panel, Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu promised that all recommendations from the findings will be considered. Though many have criticized the Nigerian Army for their misconduct during the incident, we must not forget to commend Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu for allowing the report to see the light of the day, even though he knew it might indict his government. Part of the findings from the panel revealed how Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu invited the Nigerian Army to Lagos State before the hierarchy of the Nigerian Army deployed its soldiers to the scene of the incident on that fateful day. If not for his invitation, there wouldn't have been soldiers at the Lekki toll gate on that fateful day. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. Though he knew the report might indict his government, Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu did not make any attempt to stop Nigerians from knowing the contents of the report. This shows that he is committed to making amends, as well as ensuring that those who were responsible for the unwarranted killings are brought to justice. What do you have to say about this? Let us read some comments from Nigerians. Our first comment here says, "We pray other governors should emulate Governor Sanwo-Olu, taking responsibility for their wrong." Our next comment here says, "If Sanwo-Olu invited soldiers, did he invite them to come and kill the youth, or for security or protective reasons? Is it not clear now those that ordered the killings? If it was Sanwo-Olu's order, won't he block the panel's findings? Nigerians, let's think right." You have a fair point. Someone else is talking. You have a fair point here. But you should know that the army won't have operated in a state without his awareness. Our next comment here says, "Please stop being unnecessarily defensive on the role or the side of Sanwo-Olu, because in all situations where the cowardly, Fulanized military were invited to oppress their people in the name of ensuring law and order, they always and predictably end up committing massacre, such as in River State, where Wike invited them in Obigbo. Even Opuzadima invited them in Imo State, and Sanwo-Olu in Lekki toll gate." I will end by saying he should live with his conscience and the mercies of God. Please don't forget to give us a like and please hit on the notification button for more authentic news. Remember, your number one is blog. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.